Hey John, Whisky Monster here, John Glaser from Compass Box Whisky. It's a, like a star, I don't have to mention. So, five questions, five answers. What's the hardest part of your job? It's going more
the
than
numbers.
Two. Numbers?
The numbers.
Money?
Money.
Totally.
Yeah, that's why I think.
Wonderful. That was first. Second part, easy going. Other than Compass Box whiskies, what's your favorite brand or expression? Like the one that's sticking in your mind.
Well, I'm a huge fan of malt whiskies from the Clan Nation Distillery. I'm also a huge fan of whiskey from the Springbank Distillery.
All right. So, any bottles? Just one bottle.
Just that. I just love the whole approach and the distinctiveness that they build into just about everything.
All right. One more question. I'm just thinking right now. You can tell that. You have any? Go.
Not right now. You can focus on the camera. And
What was the hardest whiskey for you to make?
Silent.
Why?
It's now retired, of course, because we've got a gap in our supply of the casks, the types of whiskeys we need. Because it's so delicate, and getting the balance of the components is so challenging, because if you don't get it perfect, if it's not perfect, you can tell, because it's all so delicate. It's such a delicate balance.
I got one. We spoke about the designs of the labels, but normally most of the whisky makers, and they just put a piece of paper and write down the cask number, blah blah. But what made you want to create such good designs?
Good design and transparency.
Yeah.
Well, both of them. Good design and transparency, because I was inspired by the wine business, particularly the wine business where I grew up in America, where people can do anything they want on the label. Yeah, they can be creative, they can be whimsical if they want. Where some of my favorite producers, like Calera, on the back label, every single vineyard sourced for that bottling with the percentages, you know, the types of yeast used, all the details there. And I'm totally inspired by the wine business. Why not?
Yeah. Okay, one question. I'm living in the States, the Turkish living in the States, so we got a lot of your whiskies in the States, we know them. But if you were to create a whiskey for Turkey, I gave you some hints about what we like. What would you do? Tough question.
It sounds like something like the K&L we tried might be the roughly kind of style. So something with some older malt whiskies aged in sherry casks, and just, you know, the right amount of peat, not to take over, but just to create an underlying complexity.
All right.
Sounds like, from what you said.
Wonderful. So
maybe five, but I got one as well. If you were to penetrate a new market, which would be the first whiskey from your core range that you should put first?
Hedness. Our grain whiskey. Compass Box Hedness.
Unfortunately, I have an extra question too. Sorry for that.
This is seven questions now.
I have to pay for that, right?
I'll make you pay when I come to San Francisco.
Yeah, please do that. Out of whiskey question. What's your favorite beer?
My favorite beer?
Yeah.
I think that's a really hard question. I don't have a favorite.
But fine. Let's go for the style.
Classic West Coast IPA.
Hazy or?
Maybe not. But I don't care, actually. Yeah. I've been 54 years old and I started drinking Sierra Nevada Pale Ale when I was...
Sorry, 22?
54. When I was 24 or whatever. And so that style and that particular brand has a meaning for me. So, and that's what opened my eyes to what beer can be back then, when there were so many bland beers on the market in America. Where that changed my whole way of thinking. So it's kind of an emotional connection, even though I don't drink it very much anymore.
So, reported from Compass Box headquarters, let's say, in London. We had fun here with Mr. John Glaser and my friend Sarp and Jim from Turkey. We'll post whatever we tried today as soon as possible. So, bye-bye.
Cheers.